Hey, good morning to Sankins Nevis. It's 4 minutes after 8 o'clock. Welcome to Island Tea, and this is got Jamster on the mic here. And we got Kortensia. AZ is caught in traffic, so let's hope he gets here in one piece. What's up?
Good morning. I am good. Yourself, Jamster?
I'm good.
Alright, good morning to everyone in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. For those of you listening to us in the diaspora, a pleasant good morning and welcome to today's edition of Island Tea. It's the 21st of March, 2024. I want to start off this morning on a great note, on a good note, on a light note, and to let folks know that Good Samaritan still exists. So there was a post on Facebook that says that this young lady is trying to find a young man. She was in this, her and her daughter was in Rams the other day, and they had about three items, and they didn't have enough money to buy the three items. There was a slim fellow behind us watching, and he was pushing an empty cart. He gave them the cart and told them to pick up the stuff they wanted. She said she laughed. And he smiled and say, "I'm serious." And she said she went around and she picked up a few things that came up to $100. He said, "No, pick up some more stuff and don't worry about how much it is." So she proceeded to pick up some more stuff as her daughter just had a new baby. She said everything came up to $656.76. And the guy just paid for them. And then he just walked out of Rams. He didn't leave a name or anything. She said she was shocked. She can't believe what had just happened because she had been laid off from work. So she proceeded to ask the cashier who the guy was. The cashier told her he worked at Boozy's. So she went over to Frigga Bay to find the guy at Boozy's to extend extra thank you, but was told he doesn't work there. She was given a number that she proceeded to call, but it was unavailable. So she just wanted this guy to know that she's grateful and thank you. However, she still wants to find him. What if that was a guardian angel in disguise that just paid and disappeared? Yeah, hey. Very well knowing that she lost her job and both her and her daughter and her new grandbaby needed the help.
Yes, wonderful news. Pleasant morning, and such a good way to start the morning off.
Yeah,
this morning.
Good Samaritan still
exists.
Yes, like
this. Exactly. And so there are persons out there who are willing to assist persons where they can, when necessary and when they are able. And so that's a wonderful story that you have shared this morning. And I'm sure it would inspire all of us to do what, and others to do what we can to make someone's day brighter than they started.
Okay, so before we continue to, that was good news. I have some in other news. We're looking for Miss Ada Ward Blois. She's from Stadium View Sandy Point, St. Kitts. She's 84 years young. She's 5'7". She's brown skin and her hair is gray. The last time she was seen was at 12:45 p.m. on March the 19th, 2024. And it's the police is offering for the public. The public assistance is being solicited to locate Ada Ward Blois of Stadium View Sandy Point, St. Kitts. She has Alzheimer's. I hope she's safe. She was last seen by a relative at her home on March 19, 2024, around 12:45 p.m. So if anyone has any information concerning the whereabouts of Miss Ada Ward Blois, please contact the nearest police station.
Yes, and so we wish persons to take the information, use the information as best as they can to try to come to some sort of solution, to come to some sort of, you know, when it's a solution in terms of, you know, her being found.
Yes.
Yes.
Because with Alzheimer's, she just probably wandered off and now she doesn't know how to get back home.
You know, that condition, when you think about it, when I think about it, I said to myself, wow.
I don't know if I lose my mind. I say that all the time.
Yeah, because imagine being at an age that you're already vulnerable.
Yeah.
And not having the mental capacity as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, and from studies, it seems like more and more persons are exposed to that condition. Yes. So I have an article that I wish to share. It's from Loop Caribbean. And it says, or it asks the question, is the Caribbean happy? And six highlights from the 2024 World Happiness Report. So Finland has, again, based on this article, topped the 2024 World Happiness Report as the happiest country in the world. So, Kortensia, I know you travel and you had a chance, you know, you were a hostess and everything like that. Have you ever been to Finland?
No.
I because when I think about this and I think to the fact that they have topped the report, the World Happiness 2024 report, Hey, Jamso, there's something playing in the background. Yeah. Okay, so we're back. It was kind of, because, you know, it's different when you have beats in your in the back of your mind. So when you have words, you understand it. Yeah. Yes. So, okay. So we have the report, the 2024 report, and it says, according to the 2024 Happiness Report, the happiest country in Latin America and the Caribbean might be Costa Rica, which entered the top 20 for the first time. And so they have asked six, they have highlighted six things from the report as it relates to the Caribbean. Mm-hmm. And they have said, older, this is number one that they have said. They said, mm-hmm. older equals less happy in Latin America and the Caribbean. So they're saying, according to the report, populations that grow older become less happy in the Latin American Caribbean region. It says, in Latin America and the Caribbean, there is a general downward trend across ages less than 60, with an increase thereafter for females. Male and female happiness is equal under the age of 30, with a growing age gap thereafter favoring females. It says, number two, women are generally unhappier. It says, across the board, women reportedly were unhappier than men, a trend that has also been apparent in the Latin American Caribbean regions. They say females have more frequent negative emotions at all ages. For the world as a whole, the average frequency of the selected negative emotions is higher for females than males, with the gender gap growing slightly from young to old. It also says, number three, equal access to amenities, a key indicator of happiness. This is a quote. It says, inequality in the distribution of happiness reflects inequality of access to any of the direct and indirect supports for well-being, including income, education, healthcare, social acceptance, trust, and the presence of supportive social environments at the family, community, and national levels. It goes on to say, people are happier living in countries where equality of happiness is greater. Number four, it says, millennials, Gen Zs, are more likely to help others. So millennials and Gen Z generations were more likely to help others. That's another key indicator. So persons, you know, those, that generation is, but it also says that same generation is the loneliest generation. So millennials in Latin America and the Caribbean join worldwide trends in feeling lonelier than Gen X and Boomers generations. Those were the generations before. And so despite social connections, so he says despite social connections and the you know, we have social media and the like, those kind of platforms, even with those platforms, millennials, they feel much lonelier than the other generations. And I guess we could, when I read that and when I saw it, I said I could understand it because social media is all about the technology. And but it's not really people, it's people to people communication, but not the face to face, in person communication and socialization.
But it says loneliness is almost twice as high among millennials than among those born before 1965.
Mm-hmm. I guess it's because we're so caught up into the cell phones, we're so caught up with the Facebooks, the platforms that
we
type.
Thinking people living
we type behind our computers.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because people, go ahead, Chef.
Yes.
Folks, we have Chef in the building.
Yes, we do. Yes.
I don't know. Like, I think social media gets a lot of flack, but I feel like what contributes to loneliness and sadness in a lot of younger people is, like, for instance, they say we have more anxiety in the world than ever before. But we also have more debt. We also have more rules, more regulations, you know? Back in my mother them days and stuff, and they had no fence around the yard, everybody was free. Oh. If you're hungry, you could have got on the bench, somebody give you two fish. Now you have student loans, now you have rent, now you have this. You can't keep a goat in your yard because they log and tell you, the neighbor got 10 stinking dog over there on your nose, but you can't keep a goat that you could get a little milk or a little meat from. So I feel like the whole lot of stress that the world is under, especially financial stress. Mm-hmm. And then remember, we've had like, what, 3 financial crashes in the last 30 years. Mm-hmm. Like every 8 years, you have a financial crash. People are most lonely and sad. You can't take your problem to nobody. Ain't nobody going to help for you. So you feel like you're sitting alone and you feel like a failure.
So how do people before 1965, Chef? How are they happy and
tell us.
We are not happy then?
How
minus again, the goat and the fish and,
again
and
for,
the freeness.
Okay, simple. Like, okay, we underestimate the power of having a simple life, right? When our parents would tell you they get up, they really had to rush. They ain't gonna bank pan the back. They ain't gonna this. They're like, when did today? Think about when you were growing up. I remember growing up, hardly anybody worked, especially when sugar cane was off. It's like most people, your mothers and different people, like they had
the mothers were more home.
Yeah.
Back then.
Yeah. And then it's like even the guys, people would work. Most people did farming or whatever. They work the early morning. If you ever go out in the early morning and work, you feel good. And by the heat of the day, you're back home. People ate better too. You had access to better food. You had, well, at least in my area, like we had fish. You had fish coming in. And food is a really, really, really important factor when it comes to your mental health and your overall function.
Because because they planted it back then? Because I think people back then probably had diseases and stuff like the NCDs, but nobody knew because they worked so hard.
I don't think so. You know why? Mm-hmm. They want to convince us that we're healthier now. No. Go back in your memory and think about your grandmother. Okay, look at the women now. A lot of women have, for lack of a better word, we call it the belly knee. Everybody belly going down and the knee now. You know what that is? That is hormonal imbalance due to stress. The female body is not used to that. And that's it. When I was growing up, all the women had, they used to like the belt.
Yeah,
the waist belt. Uh-huh. And the big bum and the titty up.
Yeah.
And it's like they didn't have these kind of shape. And the body is showing us people are stressed.
Oh, wow.
So you're saying that, but what about the social media? Because I think as well that social media does play a role in creating that loneliness because social media creates that platform that you interact with so many people, but platform. You still don't interact with persons face to face, that connection. Mm-hmm. Everyone, when they go home, they're on their cell phones. Mm-hmm. You could have conversations and persons are here next to you. And sometimes you're having conversation with the same person next to you on the phone. Uh-huh. You understand?
Mm-hmm. So, well,
or in groups, you understand, and communicating. So it takes away that people interaction, mm-hmm. that mm-hmm. connection, because you know,
you know, I take away a lot to mm-hmm. Azard. Again, maybe I go up in country, eh? Send point. Let me tell you, every week you had at least 2-3 people, 2 neighbors in front defense, a draft fair match it and abuse downtown and argue because they had way more interaction and they also had way more arguments, right? Mm-hmm. People were more busy, who were you going to your house and so now everybody on social media. So yes, you have less interaction there. But as far as with the young kids too, I don't blame social media alone for their lack of communication skills. When we were in school, we had to do subjects like comprehension, we had to do language arts, we had to do literature and stuff. Mm-hmm. No, we study for CXC, your teacher bring a bunch of past papers, give you. So they're just remembering what might come on a test. Yeah. We actually had to learn, discuss, yep. present. So when you talk to a lot of young children, they have 12, 13 subjects and they can't communicate. They don't know how. Mm-hmm. So yeah. couple that with the distance and you know, you can type and stuff. I think for a lot of people, social media really is the escape, because sometimes you think, well, all these things you got on you and you're ready to bun down town and you're gone and you see some Jamaican and they say, I can't say it. I'm going to say the B word.
Don't say it.
It's like you get a really, you know, people just aren't there to escape. Mm-hmm. And they're not escaping social media. They're escaping the hardness of the reality.
Well, you spoke about food, Chef. And so there's this article, right? And it says Happiness Day. And this article was published March 2022 around this time when they're talking about happiness and the world happiness report and everything like that. And it says 5 staple foods that can increase your happiness. So let's see. So it says happiness can be derived from many things like a new job, a trip to an exotic location, or even a gift from a loved one. Here in the Caribbean, our great weather, amazing beaches, almost unspoiled natural environment, and music are listed as some of the reasons why we are known to be some of the happiest people on the earth. Mm-hmm. But did you know that there are some of our very own day seasonal food that also contribute to our overall happiness? And it says that a study here by the University of California found that foods that primarily consist of fruits, vegetables, complex carbohydrates, protein, and good sources of fat have been associated with producing positive emotions that are lasting in individuals. Additionally, foods high in fat and carbohydrates are like highly processed food, though they may help dissipate negative emotions in a short term. Research has suggested that they do not promote happiness in a long term and can even be detrimental to one's happiness.
Yes.
So we look at it and it's, these are the foods. Mangoes.
One and of it's them. Not good for you.
What? What? Are you allergic now?
No. It has sugar. It has sugar.
Hello, Lord. All sugars are not created equal, sweetheart.
But if you
our bodies run on sugar, is a type of sugar.
But if you have, if you're pre-exposed
to diabetes,
yeah,
you wanna get a joke? Like, I know people who have diabetes and they have them eating up that thing, but don't eat fruits. But they got them on the equal, and they got them drinking the Ensure and all these nonsense.
Ensure is high in sugar, and do equal is not good.
Yeah.
Most of these foods, you know what they come with? A lot of fiber. You know what fiber does? Helps to negate sugar. You know what the difference is in sugar is? A lot of us out there drinking the white sugar ain't even sugar cane sugar. It's GMO beet sugar, okay?
Yeah.
A lot of our food ain't even the food, is the fakeness of the food. Yeah.
So it says mangoes. It says every island in the Caribbean has its own mango variant. Just a bite of this juicy, brightly colored ball of sunshine is enough for you to go back to your favorite memories from July, August breaks as a child.
You know what I also learned years ago too? Mango actually has a substance in it that allows you, it helps your body to cope with heat. That's why it blooms in the summer.
It mangoes? Also says that this
it
year
helps help your body cope with
this
heat.
Also says that, well, mangoes are packed with happy hormone known as tryptophan. And it says that just 1 cup of mangoes contain 0.02 grams of that. And it says the hormone is known to in turn reduce depression and anxiety, as well as improve sleep and other bodily function.
Tryptophan. And then you also have, like, when we were growing up again, you hear all the older people, I didn't have it, but the older people like to talk about the cocoa tea. Because, you know, you see chocolate. But we have chocolate growing here, and it comes in a pot. When you take it out, you eat the fruit, it's like a sauce up inside. They roast the seeds. They made their own natural cocoa. Chocolate is full of so much happiness-promoting compounds, right? But the chocolate we get is fake. It's a little bit of dried out cocoa powder mixed with a lot of hydrogenated fats to mess up your heart, all kind of dairy. And then we think, so with the little scraping or whatever in the chocolate, the sugar is, you crash afterward, but they were getting the real direct, hardcore, raw chocolate.
When I went to St. Lucia, I saw the whole process, and then I bought all the local chocolates, even the one with the ginger, et cetera, et cetera.
And good gin.
You know what other fruits that this article indicated? And they're touching so far two of my favorite fruits. Next one is banana. It says whether you like bananas by themselves or with yogurt or in a smoothie, including a serving of this fruit in your diet will boost your happiness. Bananas are rich in vitamin B6, which is needed by your body to naturally create serotonin.
Serotonin.
So it says that. So you know, I remember one time, you know, when I was at the University of West Indies. And I just, for whatever reason, I just took a handful of bananas, and I was like, you know what? This is my dinner for the night. And I think about it, and then it could have been perhaps maybe one of them stress relievers, in fact, because you just felt better. Well, I just felt better, you know? So, yeah, and I just, I love bananas.
What type of bananas? The small ones, the fig ones?
They call that, they have the small ones. They have this.
Call them Hardy.
Yeah? Well, they got the small ones.
Some people call them lady fingers.
The small ones. Those small ones are really nice. But
ooh, caller, go ahead. Yes. You're live on Alan T. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning. How are you doing?
You're making me feel great this morning, man. Give me an excuse to eat more fruit, especially mango, chocolate. You know, that's great. I was wondering though. We know that there is this thing about, you know, eating local ground provisions and so on. I saw an article there which said people in Dominica, because of their diet, ground provisions and so on, they tend to live longer. Mm-hmm. But we don't know, at least I don't think, there is research to back that. And I was wondering if that's not an area that we should be promoting, you know, more research into our diet, not in terms of what we get from North America, okay, or the research that they produce, but our local research that would confirm that eating local food, fresh food, and so on, is actually good for health, and it's backed by scientific analysis, you know, of whatever products are in there, something like what you've been doing, and you know, what the active ingredients are that promote a healthy body, you know, that kind of thing. We know that we normally say that, but I think it would be more convincing if it's backed by adequate research and hopefully local research, you know.
So can I ask a question?
It might too give us an idea of what is causing high rates of, let's say, cancer and non-communicable diseases like diabetes and so on, okay? Because a lot of it is conjecture. A lot of it is we think, but the research, I think, is inadequate in that respect. Okay. So, you know, maybe it's a good area for us to invest in, you know, producing the data that would guide our way of living, you know, what we do, what we eat, what we consume generally. Because I don't think there's enough data, enough scientific research locally or even Caribbean that would help in that respect. It's just a thought.
Okay, so we're going to Oh yeah. So
Hi.
Yeah. Hello?
Okay, you know, I understand that we asked for scientific research, eh? But a lot of the research that we rely on comes from people that neither eat what we eat, live where we live, or have the experience that we have. And I find that as Caribbean people, and we have so many bulbs and doctor this, and I find in the Caribbean we really, really slacking with that, because where's the research? I personally don't need no research to tell me that, because just go back in your memory. We need to couple scientific research with history, because you can convince people of anything you want, right? But people must think back. When I was growing up, hardly anybody had anything named diabetes and all these things. Was before the age of 60. You didn't have nothing.
But that might have been diagnosis, though.
But okay, you, if somebody
the diagnosis part,
you
as
think
I,
so?
I, yeah, as I mentioned yeah. earlier, maybe because they worked too hard, or worked hard, they controlled it. Mm-hmm. But with us just right. eating and sitting down and not doing what we
but
supposed to
do. But
then
is it a problem then that we our sedentary lifestyle is the problem and not necessarily that, because I okay.
Okay, so before let me finish the article.
Oh, okay.
So the food, yeah. Yeah, okay. we'll take a break, yes.
Okay, Mr.
Yeah.
McMahon, okay. when we come back, you can call back.
The quantities, that's another thing we don't do. I mean, if you take excess...
Okay, Mr. McMahon, we're taking a break. We're taking okay. a break, Mr. McMahon. We have to yeah, take right a now. Break, yes.
We're different. We're 98.9 WIN FM.
This is an important announcement from the Development Bank of St. Kitts and Nevis. The Development Bank is conducting an important exercise to update its records. From March 18th to May 10th, 2024, independent evaluators will visit properties held as collateral. To accurately assess market value, they'll need to access both interior and exterior areas. We kindly ask for your cooperation during this time. If you have any concerns, feel free to reach out to Ms. Bristol, 465-2288, extension 1113, or via email at kbristol@skndb.com. As we continue making a sustained positive difference in your life, we say thank you for your understanding and support.
Shop, hunt, and win this Easter with ShopTDC. Hop over to ShopTDCGroup.com, register, and start hunting. Search the website for hidden eggs and crack them open to discover amazing deals, exciting giveaways, and more. But wait, customers who spend $250 or more are automatically entered for a chance to win weekly prizes. Don't miss out on the excitement. Visit ShopTDCGroup.com today to start hunting. Promotion ends April 6th, 2024. Terms and conditions apply. Shop anywhere. Shop anytime.
And we're back on Island T as we continue this interesting discussion.
Let me finish the list of
you finish and then myself and Chef will come
guys,
back with what
before
we were discussing.
I even finish the menu,
I want to talk about the food.
Are you ready to dig in? We have a call.
Oh, boy. Caller, good morning. You're live on Island T.
Yes, good morning.
Okay, we lost that caller. Okay. So, Azad?
Yes. So, hurry the up next the one is fish. After fish, they have pigeon peas. Uh-huh. And then the last one, they have breadfruit.
Mm. Okay. Yeah.
Chef wins this morning.
So, you know why she's not being so happy.
I had up to last night and probably have today.
Ooh, so yes. Do we still have a call, Jamsica? We lost that one? Okay. Mm-hmm. But, ooh, so we have to start consuming more breadfruit.
Yeah.
Call up ahead. You're live on Island T. Good morning.
Yes.
Yeah, man. Greetings.
Good morning. Greetings.
Great phone, my man. I was into it. But as I started to say that your girl is today, so big up, still,
Uh-huh. Well, you said me hear that part.
I say your girl brought it today. Got big up, still.
Yeah, tell me the name, because, tell me the Azri. Name. Oh, Azri. Yeah, me, oh, yes, this is Azuri's dad?
Yes.
Yes.
I was in the program with you, man.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. So happy birthday to Azari out there. Happy birthday, Azari.
Happy birthday, Azari.
I saw her pictures. And yes, yeah, so I saw her pictures. The days go by so fast nowadays days that I didn't even pick up that. I know she's in match, but I didn't even pick up that today as well. So my apologies. Happy birthday, Azari. Yes.
I know that.
Thank you. I have to message her now, you know, because I can't. Thank you for allowing me not to miss the day.
I know you're interested. You know what to do.
Thank you so much.
Best love, man. Yes. Have a great day.
Thank you.
So you said pigeon peas.
I said pigeon peas.
You know why Siobhan is happy.
And the breadfruit lady over here, you know. Just a bundle of energy, positive, happy energy. Yes, we have another call.
Caller, go ahead. You're live on Island T. Good morning.
Good morning to Azard and I guess them there. Good morning. Morning.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
I am listening to the program very carefully.
Yes.
I'm talking about the natural food in this soil. The God created, like the sweet potato, the pumpkin, the carrot, the tanya, the dashi, the yam. Those are things where we used to live on back in the 70s. Because my father do nothing, my father and my mother do nothing but walk mountain ground. And these are the things we live off of. And I don't think you need no research who use these things. These are natural food. I made to understand sweet potato is one dish, the hoist. What do you call it again? The hoist. Provision. Sweet potato, rich in a lot of things.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's and one of my favorite foods.
It even help with diabetes.
Even cancer, sweet potato.
Yep.
You know?
Yes, that's
and
one of my
favorite. And these are the things that doctor tell you, when the doctor specialist tell you that, oh, too much starch, too much this, too much that. In them time, we know it's a thing of starch, we know it's a kind of sugar.
A lot of it
we know it's a kind of pressure.
Yeah.
We know it's a kind of diabetes and them thing there.
But caller, would you agree that...
I'm in my 50s. I'm reaching me close to 50, going to 60. Doctor, tell me I got pressure.
Oh, gosh.
I got pressure. Mm-hmm. I got to take pills and so because my hypertensive and all these things.
Do you take
is
the pills?
Is the kind of food where we eat now? The processed food and all these things?
All the ham,
is this processed thing, you know? The natural thing that's about us.
Full of hidden salt.
And lady, you're right, you're just so right with what you're saying. Yeah, you need no research who are these things.
But
these are the things we eat, come up and live after.
Carla, I said we don't need the research, right? But I'll correct myself. In the Caribbean, we're always behind. We were told in, like, maybe my mother's, she's, like, in her 60s now. Sorry, mommy, sorry. But they were told that don't eat all these things, they're bad for you. But we have not updated ourselves. So let me correct myself when I say I don't need no research. But for the people who are saying they need the research, do it yourself. Mm. See what he just said about the sweet potato?
Yeah.
That has been updated. We ain't updated down here yet. Yeah. Remember when they tell us don't eat pear? Remember when they tell us don't eat egg?
Yeah.
Breadfruit is all over the world now. They're growing breadfruit in Alaska and all. They're trying to process breadfruit. Hawaii, all over, you know why? Superfood. Where they tell Bolt when he eat all the yam and the breadfruit, then tell him stop? Because of all the natural steroids in it? Do your own research.
I wrote it right here.
How many of our doctors go back and update the information? And doctors are not nutritionists. I had a major issue years ago. And when I had to deal with my doctor for my nutritional needs, I became very depressed and very anxious. Mm-hmm. I had to be sent to a nutritionist.
My mother had 14 hours.
Yes.
Okay. She got twin twice.
Okay.
My mother and my father were mountain gong. And I never see my mother and my father going to the doctor. And nothing like that, no diabetes, no sugar, nothing. They eat the natural food. Just with chocolate. Can't eat the chocolate at morning time.
Uh-huh.
Natural chocolate. The natural
tea.
Cocoa.
Mm-hmm.
And these things we used to get in our tea. Mm-hmm. And we were so strong, go out, play football, play cricket, and do all kind of thing and no sickness.
Yep.
You know where the sickness used to come from? Sometimes when meals come around.
Mm-hmm.
Chicken pox.
Okay.
And all those things.
Okay.
And you know, the other thing named mums.
Yes.
You used to sort of a jawbone, big. And this same hot sweet potato, that's why you go put on it. You put on a roast hot sweet potato on it, mm-hmm. and your bone go down.
Yep.
These are the things we used to live off of. This was a cultural thing we used to live off of. Anyway, let somebody get that first.
You see what he said about sweet potato? Uh-huh. Do you know one of the treatment for moms, right?
Yeah.
When you do the research, again, we need to do our own research. One of the main ingredients in that treatment for moms come out of sweet potato.
Yeah.
So our people knew what they were doing. And we are too easily fooled. Look, you don't look at the evidence. Think back. Those of you who are old enough, think back about how vibrant people were, how healthy they were. And they're saying, okay, they were just not diagnosed. Sickness don't need a diagnosis for you to recognize it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure by the time you reach to the doctor, it's because you've noticed that something is off in your body. But sickness has a look and a feel.
Yeah.
So, okay, so... We
have another caller.
Oh no. I was just saying, you know, we know that. Oh, we have a caller?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was even to mention that even the cow had a say in that last call. Caller, go ahead. You're live on Island Tea.
Just one quick intervention.
Okay, Mr. McMahon.
One of the reasons why the research is needed is because the quantities matter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Food stuff, those are chemicals, right? And they interact with other, with body chemistry that produce particular outcomes, particular results. I was told by a doctor once, for instance, that if you eat too many mangoes, you can suffer from vitamin A poisoning,
mm-hmm.
right? So the research is important, not only to tell us what's good for us, but the quantities of what we should consume. Because we can overdo things.
Yeah, we have
that was the point.
Okay,
of research as well.
Thank you, okay. Mr.
McMahon.
We have
Mr.
this. McMahon. We have someone on the Facebook. She says we should consume food in moderation, and also goes on to say you don't know what most people had back in the day, as most were not diagnosed. He also says too much processed food causes inflammation in the body, which leads to a lot of diseases we have now, and then. Chef, this person says, I don't agree with Chef's mm-hmm. point. You don't have the data to back up that information. And another uh-huh. and another one was also we are eating heavy meals at night and mm-hmm. go to bed. And when mm-hmm. and she says when she was growing up, our heavy meals were lunchtime.
As far as the data again, as I would say, we get everything last down here. All this stuff I'm telling you, it's documented, it's out there. Even if you go on certain sites, the research that they're doing, even for menopause, they're using certain yams to treat menopause. It's all sorts of stuff that they've rediscovered in food. But we're saying that
mm-hmm.
you going to a doctor and going to somebody who is specialized in nutrition are two completely different experiences. Most doctors are versed in giving you a drug. The nutritionists are versed in telling you what to eat and how food affects your body. And as far as interactions, how much mango, they will tell us things like this, eh? Or if you eat too much mango, you could get this poisoning. But how much do I have to eat? Sometimes the amount you have to eat, you will physically never be able to eat that amount. I watch my mother and people eat buckets of mango. You know what they get? Little diarrhea. You know too much vitamin C give you? Diarrhea. It gives you a flush.
Okay,
you might have to eat 10,000 mango to get that vitamin A poisoning.
Another article I wanted to discuss is the fact that, you know, Grenada joins Caribbean.
As I just cut me off, string. Let's shift. Okay,
I wanted to look at some other things, man. So we have Grenada joins Caribbean and adjacent regions for Carib Wave 24. So, we're not the only ones who are going through the process as it relates to tsunami awareness and the like. Grenada is also participating. And so it says that Grenada will participate with the rest of the Caribbean and adjacent region for Carib Wave 24. The tsunami exercise will be held on Thursday, March 21, 2024. So it's today. And remember, we had the persons here from NEMA mm-hmm. and the fire and rescue services, the police force, just last week, Friday, when they spoke about the preparations that had to be made today as well. And so the annual exercise, which began in 2011, allows emergency management organizations throughout the region to exercise their operational lines of communication, review tsunami response procedures, and promote tsunami preparedness to improve tsunami warning systems effectiveness. So these are things that we have to always be cognizant of. We have to be aware of what is going to happen if it were to happen and what we do.
Tsunami, that can't woman.
We said
we have to be aware of the tsunami.
Yes. So the overarching objectives of this exercise and the exercise and is to exercise and evaluate communications between mm-hmm. the regional tsunami service provider and the member states to evaluate the tsunami procedures and programs within member states and territories. So and that would be important because you want to make sure that there is a, you know, a regional approach between member states, and you want to make sure that member states are doing what they ought to do in terms of ensuring that they are prepared. You know, and it says that the National Tsunami Warning Protocol will be tested during this exercise. Additionally, NADMA will endeavor, and I guess that's what they would refer to as NEMA back in that country, to endeavor to promote the awareness. And so we know that that is happening already in St. Kitts and Nevis. Is supposed to be happening. And last time they were here, they indicated that this time it's going to be in the Date Bear region area.
So folks, yes. participate. You never know when this is going to come to us.
Yeah,
I don't even want to say come
no,
to us.
No, nothing coming to us.
Exactly. I hesitated. So let us move on to something else, since Azad is just moving on, right?
Yeah.
So isn't Kate Middleton a normal person? Shouldn't she get surgery if her body decides? Why are people minding their business so keenly?
People don't have enough to do.
Mm-hmm.
You see, they're stressing themselves again over Kate, and Kate isn't even stressing over that.
I mean, I remember which one it is. Kate is the half black one or the
no,
one,
Kate
the
is
one.
A full English lady. Kate is William's wife. Like, people are snooping into her surgery.
What surgery she had? A BBL? God, that's the only surgery you would be on anybody.
Listen. Imagine her coming out with a BBL. Oh. Shama, why you want me to laugh like this on radio? Why?
So, we have a caller.
Caller, go ahead. You're live on Island T. Good morning.
You remind me of my grandmother.
Oh, gosh. Thank you.
You're welcome. You know, thanks for taking our call, and thanks for the information flow so far. You know, the thing about the things that we're eating, that is what we call food, that they are addictive, you know.
Yes.
Especially the gummies.
Yeah, very addictive. Very addictive. All right. We're hearing this song about sweet potato and the like. You know, the best way to consume sweet potatoes are incorporate it in your smoothie.
My mother used to give us a piece of raw potato whenever she was peeling it.
Oh.
And raw fish oil.
Yes, chew up that. Yes. When I put my smoothie together, I put in a piece of sweet potato. You know, I put in up, you know.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I remember it was, when you get what you get.
Okay.
Yeah.
You put in a piece of sweet potato. Sometimes I put in piece of beetroot, you know, piece of carrot.
Yes.
Yeah, because you get them things raw and you get what they got inside of them, mm-hmm. especially if these things are grown organic,
mm-hmm.
you know? Yeah, I tell you. Me hear you say sweet potato is your favorite, my brother. Me listen, me love it, you know.
Why? If I could eat that every day, you know? You know? Because it's such a superfood, it's a complex carb, and mm-hmm. so it takes a longer period to break down, and so your body is full longer, so you don't have to always be eating, and it really helps in terms of diet and exercise as well.
And even like green bananas have this thing called complex starch or anti-starch, but it actually works in the reverse with sugars. It lowers your sugar.
Mm.
And when I eat green bananas, I have to eat it with a starch because it actually lowers my sugar.
Okay.
And people use it for diabetes treatment.
All right. Yeah. Talking about green banana. You know, the best porridge we eat in Jamaica is green banana porridge. No, I'm going to bring it to the kids.
Yeah.
We just get just put 12 of them in a blender, blend them out, smoothie-wise, and it's powers that. Me just tell me, add me hemp milk and me nice, me cinnamon and this and that. No, you see, when you eat that porridge there, man, and the next porridge they got in Jamaica too, which they might not be able to do it much around here because they not them no ITEL again.
Peanut porridge.
Mm-hmm. Peanut porridge. Yes. Oh, yeah.
me know me brother.
If you go to UV, you must remember that.
Yes, peanut porridge, yes.
Peanut porridge in the morning. No, you see when you consume that, no man, me tell you, man, people are miss out, you know.
Yes.
People are consume things who are
empty.
Me keep saying it, you know. People are use empty to dig the grave, you know. It's a sad thing.
You know, Elder Ross. You know, when it comes to Jamaica and the breakfast, especially, you know. I think their breakfast is like second to none. You know, in terms of you get the peanut porridge, you get.
No. Jamaica people, Jamaica culture. No, may I tell you, man, that's the best in the world.
The variety at breakfast. I like the variety at breakfast. I like the variety at breakfast.
Man, you have choice. That is all and all. Any choice you make, you're good to go. Mm-hmm.
You know, they serve. So you get your sweet potato and stew chicken for breakfast, you know. You'll get your yam and everything for breakfast.
Those
are breakfast meals in Jamaica. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Meals. When you have breakfast in Jamaica, you can go right through till about 3 o'clock.
So you know.
At lunchtime, the breakfast is served too. For that lunchtime, me just the people, certain people just grab a patty.
Yes, and then that's a Jamaican patty. So you just I would eat the breakfast, and I would actually buy breakfast maybe twice, and use breakfast for lunch as well, because I find the lunch might not be as diverse, but the breakfast
once you
breakfast.
And you get the heavy meal, so you know.
You get a heavy meal at the beginning, so and gets lighter during the day, and then by the night, which is better.
So you know.
I get to check with again before I be up one quick. Planting.
Oh yeah.
Planting is very elder Rastafari virgin in Jamaica. Tell me, if we eat planting every day. Yeah, planting.
I'm planting the natural baby and planting.
Thank you so much for your call.
Thank you.
Okay.
Ella.
So. Thank you so much. So, just so we could you know, go back a bit about the surgery. So, the surgery. So, let's just give you a background information as it relates to that before. So, the UK hospital staff suspended. Suspected of snooping on Kate Middleton's records. So Kate Middleton is the, you know, she is queen in waiting, you know, the next
Princess
in line
of
for
Wales.
Yes, Princess of Wales. And so you have this article saying a British privacy watchdog said Wednesday it was investigating a report that staff at the private London hospital tried to snoop on the Princess of Wales medical reports while she was a patient for abdominal surgery. So it was abdominal surgery.
But you know, you could move the abdominal fat too.
Yeah. it's abdominal.
We're not saying. I said, go ahead.
You guys, if we see those.
She said you could use the abdominal, you could move that abdominal fat. So if we see those, the shift dress she wearing look a little more snug.
So it says, the Information Commissioner's Office said, and I quote, we can confirm that we have received a breach report and assessing the information provided. And it said, and the end of quote, it says, the Daily Mirror newspaper reported that at least one staff member at London's clinic tried to look at Kate's notes during her stay in January. The princess had surgery at the clinic in central London on January 16 and discharged almost 2 weeks later.
Maybe it was for, let's just say maybe it was for her appendix, since it goes to the
discharge 2 weeks, that's a long time, I find.
You mean her stay? Well, maybe it depends on her recovery period.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's a long time.
That's so funny, boy.
Yeah. So and that
recovery to her.
Yeah, and you know, a very speedy recovery, and you know, because the royal family would give information, but of course they wouldn't give the exact details. So, but when you look at what is being published, persons would speculate based, and as you said, that things jump up to you, the 2 weeks that she was in there for almost and stuff like that. We would see, or could infer that perhaps it's something serious. And we know that King Charles III is also battling at right now, as he's been diagnosed with an unspecified form of cancer. So
I really hope he gets along, Rain, because I said it's so sad that he just got in after all these years, and it looks maybe like Kortensia, his Rain.
I'm sure you're the only person wishing he get along. You're so nice. All the rest is out. They just said fire. sorry. I'll behave.
So of course we know that at the end of the day, these are individuals.
People. And normal people. They just have a little title.
Yeah, they have the title. Oh, and yeah. So, you know, it comes with the exposure. It comes with the criticism. But at the end of the day, they are persons nonetheless. So.
But in all joke aside, when I look at them royals for the kind of money they got, they could look into a little more cosmetic, what do you call intervention. Like, it just ain't not enough. It's like after Queen Elizabeth, none of them care nothing else.
Oh, boy.
When they tell me that the husband, when you see Queen Elizabeth's husband,
when they say he dead. The one that died?
I thought he did dead long time out of the picture, look. He made me out of underworld, the vampire. Like, I'm like, gosh. Oh, my God. Like, no, man.
She's not the only one that said that, because when we saw the picture of him in the back of the car, the Rolls Royce, people thought he was dead already.
Yeah, like.
Yeah, he looked very gone.
You see, the queen ate different to her. She wouldn't eat anything out of season. She ate all organic or whatever, obviously.
Yeah, because she looked excellent down to her
dad. They're taking she on with that.
But if one is to look at the way in which she managed her life and herself, she seemed to have been, from all reports, someone who was very disciplined, someone who was very dedicated to her job.
Very.
And it seemed as though she had everything done, down to a T, down to a Y. Yeah. She noted everything and performed everything.
I think she know that she was the last real royal, you know.
Like, oh, jeez.
No, for sure. Like, the outer style knows. So I think she know by.
Yeah, because she did her best. She was excellent. As we said, she looked excellent down to her debt.
Yeah.
She died fancy, I must
say. The rest of the related to her. Like,
she took the position very seriously.
Yeah.
And dedicated her life. And there was a speech that was recorded, you know, that she gave when she assumed the throne. And she said, I don't know if it was when she assumed the throne or when she gave her first address, something like that. But it was a speech that, and I don't want to be mistaken, because, you know, it's. So, but it was saying that, you know, I think when she assumed this, her reign, whether it be short or long, would be towards the dedication to her life, to her service of her country.
Yeah.
So it had to be during the time
I
of
think
her,
it's
her reign.
At her coronation.
Yeah, I think it was at her coronation. Yeah. And when I listened to those words, I said, wow, those words are very deep. And look at it, she reigned for a very long time.
Yeah, you know what she said 70. To her country there? Okay. Yeah. Not to us who out here pledging to her.
Oh boy!
I just have to train that for all the rasters out there. Yeah, we ain't gone against you.
So before we take the break, there's another article that I want us to look at, and it's Turks and Caicos. So the Turks and Caicos intercepted 95 persons who were trying to get into their island on border. So it says 95 irregular migrants were intercepted on Tuesday evening by the officers of the Royal Turks and Caicos Island Police Force Marine Branch. The migrant group, which was made up of 82 men and 13 women, were handed over to the Immigration Task Force for processing and deportation.
Where they were from?
I was looking to see where they were from. The article never indicated.
From the looks of the picture, I will assume they're from Haiti. Because, you know, it's very close to there. Yeah.
And that just reminds me of a meme I saw with some Jamaicans who are on the beach.
Sure.
Yeah, we could take a call. Caller, go ahead.
Caller, good morning. You're live in Allen T. The caller left. Aww. Yeah.
So the Jamaican was on the show and you were seeing where they actually washed up, eh? He was looking at them, but he didn't have a problem with that. They came in and he said, well, y'all here resting. Y'all resting, you're supposed to do one gun. And then his major problem was that it was more men again. And a little handful of women. He's like, no, man, we could take the women, but all this man.
So we have a caller. Caller live on Island T. Go ahead.
Yeah, Azard, me again.
Yes.
I want to tell you something about sweet potato, how it's a powerful.
Yes.
Do you know if a great sweet potato and you squeeze the juice in something and you squeeze the juice in a glass or something and drink it, it poison, you know?
And it's also a remedy for fish poison, I'm told, too.
Yeah, sweet potato.
No, sweet potato, too.
Poison.
Well,
it's poison?
Not in that sense. They say it has very high levels of vitamin D. I've heard that you doing that would actually help with if you already poison people, grate the potato and they drink the water. Well, cassava has a toxin. Certain types of cassava has a toxin for sure, but the sweet potato, not. I've never heard that. I've heard that you drink that if you have fish poisoning.
Mm-hmm. So we are on the 9 o'clock. Okay.
Okay. So can we eat a piece of it raw though? Is that good or is it poisonous?
Well, I would have done get poison long time.
Because you'll be at Gungan from the minimum when you're hungry.
So
and you dig in potato, just peel them and you eat them raw.
So we need to take a break now.
But I made you understand the juice poison.
Okay. Okay.
Anybody got any information on that? They could call in and lie.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, sir.
All right, thank you for your contribution. We'll take a short break. And today, I'm told, is the first of Tipsy Thursday. And I think, based on the conversations and the comments that I'm hearing so far by members of the panel, I'm wondering if they have gotten tipsy before the show.
Ooh, on breadfruit? I don't think so.
We're different. We're 98.9. WINN FM.
Shop, hunt, and win this Easter with Shop TDC. Hop over to shoptdcgroup.com, register, and start hunting. Search the website for hidden eggs and crack them open to discover amazing deals, exciting giveaways, and more. But wait, customers who spend $250 or more are automatically entered for a chance to win weekly prizes. Don't miss out on the excitement. Visit shoptdcgroup.com today to start hunting. Promotion ends April 6th, 2024. Terms and conditions apply. Shop anywhere. Shop anytime.
Life is unpredictable. Don't miss the opportunity to provide your loved ones with the financial protection and peace of mind coverage they deserve with the Family Indemnity Plan from Kuna Caribbean Insurance. The Family Indemnity Plan covers final expenses such as funeral costs and outstanding debt in the event you or your loved one passes away for up to $30,000. No medical examination is required. Contact your credit union or one of their approved Family Indemnity Plan providers to enroll today. To learn more, call 466-9453 or 762-2973. Visit their website at kunacaribbean.com. Kuna Caribbean Insurance, for all people.
Save the date and don't be late on Thursday, 28th March for the Agri Easter Night Market. Join us at the Bastia Public Market from 5 p.m. until 10 p.m. for your local produce, fruits, cooked food, fresh fish and meat, agro-processed goods, saltfish, coconut dumplings, conky, Bullfoot, real cook-up with and without oink. Registration forms are available at the Bastia Public Market, the Ministry of Agriculture, Building 16, Port Zante, and the Department of Agriculture, La Grete. It's the Agri Easter Night Market, Thursday, 28th March, from 5 p.m. at the Public Market. You better meet me there.
Hey, Hey, what's up, Sean?
What's up, Keisha, my girl?
I hear scrolling on my phone, and I see Shop, Hunt, and Win. What is about?
Well, Shop TDC got an Easter egg hunt where you could win prizes and giveaways.
Tell me more. How could I enter? How could I win?
So you go on shoptdcgroup.com and sign in, and Easter eggs will pop up.
Okay, so then what?
You crack open the egg and use the code to redeem the prizes and discounts at checkout.
Okay, I like this. So how much I could get up to?
Up to 30% off your purchases, plus free gifts and free shipping.
Up to 30%? This sound good, boy.
But wait, don't forget, you can win weekly prizes too, not just the discounts.
Well, Sean, this is a lot of giveaways and prizes, boy. So, tell me something. When does this promotion end?
The hunt will end on April 1st, 2024.
Well, excuse me there. Let me come off my phone because I'm going on shoptdcgroup.com to shop, hunt, and win.
Terms and conditions apply. Shop anywhere, shop anytime.
And we're back. Yes, so we're supposed to be having a representative in studio as we launch the Tipsy Thursday. Yeah, so Chevy, did you have anything to drink before you came? Did you know today was Tipsy Thursday?
No.
Yes.
I had no idea.
Yes, and so Tipsy Thursday. I think they're supposed to be coming with drinks, and so while we wait, you know,
drinks.
Yes.
What so type of drinks?
I'm still awaiting that information.
So
as
early.
Well. So I
in
am.
The morning.
Yeah, I am here, and I'm wondering what kind of drinks, and you know, they told me at 9, and I'm here waiting. I wonder if the drinks are ever going to come. You know, Jams are always talking about the food, and they never came. So I wonder if the drinks are on its way. Yes. So, yes.
Drinks.
But we also have in studio shortly, we'll be talking with Pastor Gumbs, Viomi Gumbs, and she is bringing a guest, and they're going to be having a convention shortly, and so we're going to hear more about that, and that is supposed to be exciting. So it's the Holy Spirit Conference, and Prophet Kofi is supposed to be on here as well, and that's about 9:15. And so we have Tipsy Thursdays with Corks and Screws.
Oh.
And then we're supposed to have the Holy Spirit Conference. Yes. You know,
all
when I saw
spirits this morning.
So you know, when I saw the lineup, I said, oh, that's interesting.
They're all spirits, babe.
So we await. And so while we await, we could be talking about some matters here for discussion, because we have our 9:15 already here in the studio. And so it says the Dominica Prime Minister is to make an official visit to China.
Ooh.
And the Prime Minister, Roosevelt Skerrit, will lead a delegation to China later this week as the two countries mark the 20th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic ties between them. And Skerrit also told a news conference that he would be going to Beijing at the invitation of the Chinese government, adding, and I quote, "I think it is important to mark this occasion because there can be no argument that our partnership with China has resulted in significant benefits for Dominica. Across the length and breadth of Dominica, we see the tangible investment in health, agriculture, education, and infrastructure development," end of quote. So, yes, Skerrit would be traveling to China.
Beijing.
Yeah.
Every time I hear that name, I just think Chi Chi. But that's good. I mean,
yes.
You know, the diplomatic ties between us and China is always a little controversial. African nations, Caribbean nations. I'm still making up my mind, though.
Mm-hmm. So we here in St. Kitts and Nevis have diplomatic ties with Taiwan, Republic, and China. So, you know, there are some countries that share diplomatic relations with China, while there are others like us who share diplomatic ties with Taiwan.
And we all share economic ties with China. Everything is made in China. But you have a lot of people. Mm-hmm. You know, I wonder sometimes with the argument, how much of it is American propaganda and how much of it is actually true? Because I don't, I mean, I would imagine every so-called investor that comes into a country, we must know they're coming for something for their self to gain. But sometimes I find that, you know, like these Eurocentric people want you to distrust these other races so bad. Like, why? I let me make up my mind and distrust them because I don't know what happened with you.
Mm-hmm.
But you want to convince me that these people are so bad. Let me see, because I've not seen the evidence pointing elsewhere. Let me just say that.
Yes.
But, you know, I mean, people have been doing, a lot of countries have done stuff with China. I think that we have to be careful with any investor, and we have to really weigh the pros and the cons. And I feel like sometimes we as the people feel like the politicians sell us out, but then we sell out ourselves too, because there's certain things we want. We don't ask how they're going to get it. And they go out and they sign all kind of deals, and they come back and they give us roads and lights and different things. And we say, "Whoo, we're in it now." But we don't ask where it's coming from. It's like when a woman dated a drug man. She liked the Gucci and the heels and the vacation, but she ain't asking about the blood on the hands. So sometimes we as a people have to start waking up and researching and, you know, asking where y'all getting these things.
Yeah. Precisely. And so we look at, you know, countries are going to have diplomatic relations because you know that no one person, no one country could do it by itself, especially us here. And so we have to foster that communication to enhance relation. And based on communication, you know, there are tangible benefits to it.
Like,
we have a caller. Caller, you're live on ILNT. Go ahead, caller.
Hi, morning.
Hi, good morning.
Just a quick note quiz. Do you know who Taiwan's largest trading partner is?
Could you repeat that, please? Taiwan.
Do you know who Taiwan's largest trading partner is? Your largest trading partner. Taiwan.
Yeah.
It's China.
China. Yeah, a lot of them go to work in China still daily.
So 20% of Taiwan's economy is dependent on China. So regardless of the tensions between them, they found a practical balance where China utilizes Taiwan's technology and Taiwan utilizes China's manufacturing generally. So regardless of the tensions, they found a way to make it work. That's not to say that there still isn't tension between them. So there's a quick note on that.
Yeah, and it says here that China is Taiwan's largest trading partner, accounting for 22.6% of the total trade and 19.6% of Taiwan's imports in 2022 in terms of total trade. Other major Taiwan trading partners include Japan, 9.7%, Hong Kong, 7.3%, and the Republic of Korea, 6.2%. So the China is still Taiwan's largest trading partner, as the caller indicating, and that accounting for 22.6%.
But China isn't like most American debt owed to China. As much as they make China look like it's the beast.
Ooh. Well, there was some talk as China becoming the next superpower in the world, but I think that some things might have happened they're not as fast approaching as they would have been some years ago.
Even this concept of becoming the next superpower, I find it's archaic. I find that that's a very... Okay, sorry. I feel that it's like that's such a Eurocentric view. And times are changing, and I don't think people are looking so much to become the superpower, but alliances and collaboration. Look at BRICS. We're going to see.
Go ahead, caller.
Hi, good morning.
Yes.
Morning, Azard. Good yeah, morning,
you,
Steph.
You'll have to be brief, because we only have 2 minutes until our next segment.
Hit us with it quick, sweetie. Let's go.
You never asked anyone else to have what your time was. I know what the time is, Mr. Azard. I realize there's a sequence with you and me.
No.
Please allow me to speak when I want to make my contribution. And don't try to restrict me.
I'm so sorry, sir.
I have
violated
for the past 3 consecutive times. I call in, and you're telling me about the time. I'm cognizant of what the time is. Okay, I'll give way.
Caller? Okay, let me apologize to the caller that just called in. We had no idea who was on the line. It's just that we have guests in studio, and we are being told that they're here and they're ready to speak. So it just happened that you happened to call at this time, but we are in no way prejudiced against you, and we do apologize if you feel that way. We really don't know. We don't have caller ID like back in the day, and so we don't know. So I'm so sorry. I hope you will call back later so that we can have a conversation.
Yeah, so let me just say, I am in no fact having anything against you. It's just that we have a guest in studio, and it's supposed to start at 9:15. And so when you called, we did accommodate you by receiving your call. But I had to tell you, because I don't want it to be a situation where you're in mid-sentence and I have to cut you off. So I always would, especially when we have a next guest, I always start by saying we have only a few minutes. And not just for you, but anyone who calls in at a particular time. So if you felt that way, I do apologize, but there's nothing geared towards you, okay? So okay. We're going to prepare for, it's 9:15 now, so we'll take a short break and get our guests in. Okay, yeah, okay then. So our guest is coming around, and so we have our guests, and next week is considered, we have Easter coming up, and we have Holy Thursday, and from that we have, a number of events happening as we celebrate our Easter and Easter Saints and Nevis. We know that we are very religious country, and so we have a lot of churches that are going to be doing a number of things, and so we welcome them as they come in and as they speak with us about what is happening as it relates to those activities pertaining to, Holy Thursday and the Easter. And so it is always wonderful to have our guests in studio. And so we have Pastor Gumbs in studio, and we want to say welcome to you and to, as you represent your church. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing wonderful this morning, yes. Mr. Gumbs.
Yes, so we want to say welcome to Island Tea. And we know that there is the Prophet Kofi. He is supposed to be on the Zoom, and we're going to have a discussion with him as well. And so we want you to tell us what can we expect, and when is this conference going to be?
All right. Mm-hmm. Good morning, people in Radio Land.
Yes.
I am Pastor Viomi Gumbs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, on Friday evening at 7 o'clock at the Kuna Building, there will be a Holy Spirit conference on Dr. Kofi Danso. So I want you to bring out the sick. Bring out everyone. There will be miracles, signs, and wonders happening at Kuna Building.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so tell us about Kofi. Why is he coming? What would have been some of the things that he has done?
Okay, God has given him a mandate for...
Yes, you go ahead.
God has given him a mandate for the Caribbean. Just 2 days ago, Monday, Tuesday, he was in St. Vincent, and the power of God moved mightily. Last night and night before, he's in Antigua.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tonight is the last night for Antigua. And there was, oh my, the Spirit of God moved mightily, dear. So tomorrow is our turn right here in St. Kitts.
So he touched down in St. Kitts.
He will touch down in St. Kitts. I think it's for the fourth time.
Okay, wow. Wonderful. And I think we have him on here now. Good morning. How are you doing?
Well, how are you, sir?
I am wonderful. So you have had such a powerful introduction by Pastor Viomi Gumbs. So we are expecting great things from you and your presentation and when you come and your interaction here on the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis and at the conference.
Thank you so much and thank God for every one of you. And may God bless you, WIN FM, and my great pastor, who is a resident pastor of Miracle Arena. God bless you. We are believing God for a turnaround, for a shift, and for a manifestation.
Amen.
We can only assume what God is going to do. As you already said, we just moved from St. Vincent. Now we are in Antigua. And on Friday, that is tomorrow, we are believing God to touch our lives. We are trusting God to touch our island. And I believe the presence of God will manifest like never before. I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. So tell us more about you. Tell us what you have done in the past and what has led you to what you're doing now.
Thank you very much for this opportunity. Prophet Kofi Danso is a Ghanaian from West Africa, Ghana, based in Canada. We started our ministry in Canada over 12 years now. I was in Europe before for 9 years, and the Lord moved me to Canada. One of the things that identify my life is prayer. I believe so much in prayer, and I believe that prayer is one of the greatest gifts God has given to a man.
Amen.
Prayer is our communication. Prayer is our elevation. And prayer is our connectivity to divine grace. And a man of prayer is a man that hears from God. And in the past, what I have witnessed is just mind-blowing. Number one, I have seen God pick people from nowhere and make them the head of a nation, make them the head of a family. And the most outstanding desire that I believe to me is very unique is to see people's lives saved. Because, you know, you can get a car, you can get a house, you can get married and die and still go to hell.
True.
What I preach is that make sure you are secured. Make sure your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And so it's all about salvation. It's all about people getting saved, soul winning. And so we've seen thousands of people being won. Almost every week in our service, we see that manifestation. When it comes to miracles, I've seen manifestation of miracles. And I believe that one of the outstanding miracles is to see the dead raised. And, you know, I was watching a film. It's like a documentary of a man of God who is very known in the world. Now, this generation may not have heard of him. His name is called Archbishop Benson Edahosa. And he was having a service, and they brought a dead person to the service. As a matter of fact, there was cuttings in the nose of the person. They brought the person from a mortuary. And he was just preaching as if he didn't care. He just continued preaching. And then he just took water he was drinking and poured it on the dead person, and the dead person came back to life. You know, the whole service went by. Everybody was shouting, screaming, like the first miracle of death I have ever witnessed in my life. So I was praying and I told God, please, what I saw, I like it. Give me that grace. Yeah. One day I was in the house and I saw that my parents and my siblings, the way they are moving is not normal, not knowing that my senior sister has been dead from midnight. Wow. And an ambulance has come to take her to the morgue. That was after a week after I watched the movie, the documentary. When I finished, when I heard that something was wrong in the house, I was moved by God to pray over my sister. I declared and prayed over my sister, and the devil kept on telling me, if she doesn't resurrect, there is kind of a problem, stigma. But I kept on praying. My first miracle is to see my dead sister raised out of death, came back to life. I also came to the church. And so, listen to this. I was just like, you know, a new faith. I have prayed for the dead to raise. The Lord has manifest himself. And, you know, I'm just coming to talk about it in the church as a casual way. But I made a mistake. My mistake was to say, anybody here, if you have any dead person, bring them to church. I didn't mean it. It wasn't part of my plan. Now, I know I didn't say this, but let me say this to you. I used to be afraid of dead bodies. I didn't want to be close to dead bodies. When I was preaching the following week, after I was preaching, and ran to me and said, "Prophet, they brought somebody dead. He's in a casket." I thought it was like a dream. Whilst he was speaking, the family of one who is dead brought the dead person out with cotton in the nose. I was so fearful, scared. I didn't know what to do. And all I heard is, "Let them put that person on the altar." They carried the dead person and I shouted, "Put him on the altar, put him on the altar." I was afraid. I didn't want to go closer to it. As the person hit the altar, the person got up. Just, he came out of there and he was watching around. He was like, "Where am I?" So that is one of the incredible manifestations. We have also seen cancer healed. So in the miracles, we've seen all. But right now, my greatest desire for everyone's miracle is that everybody gets saved.
Amen.
Because you can be resurrected. But yes, if your life is not pleasing God, you have no future.
True.
So the greatest miracle, if you ask me, upon all I've seen blind eyes open, I've seen the dumb speak, I've seen the deaf hear, I've seen the dead raised, I've seen all. But what I always desire is to see people change, transformed. Yes. Because when there is a saved leader, there is a saved nation.
Amen.
Where there is a saved leader, there will be a saved nation. And that's my prayer. That's one of the greatest miracles, is to see people's life change.
So you're going to be at the conference, and so you're asking a lot of sick persons to be there as
That's
well.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Persons
yes,
who
bring the sick.
Okay. Persons who so how has your experience been? I know you told us about it, but how has your experience, generally, but how has your experience been in Grenada? Is Grenada you
Saint
were?
Vincent.
Saint Vincent, sorry, yes. How was your experience in Saint Vincent just days ago?
It was marvelous. Honestly, it was marvelous. It was beyond my expectation. And one of the outstanding of this, the convention is the hunger of the people. Matthew chapter 5 says, "Blessed are those that hunger and thirst for righteousness, but they shall be filled." God don't fill you because you pray. God don't fill you because you fast. God feel because there is hunger in your spirit.
Yeah.
And I saw the hunger in the spirit of these individuals. And it was marvelous that God manifested. Let me say this. Romans chapter 8, verse 18 to 19. The Bible says that the earnest manifestations of the sons of God are witness. In other words, I said this and I believe I will not be justice if I don't mention this. This generation doesn't need explanation. Hear me again. This generation don't need explanation.
Wow.
They need manifestation.
That's right.
Because you cannot keep on saying that, St. Kitts, things are tough, so I'm not making it. My dear, somebody is in St. Kitts making it.
True.
You cannot say, "Well, I'm depressed because when I was a child, they abused me." Somebody was abused, but the person is making it.
So I don't want to misquote you, but you talk about raising the dead. Did you say that?
Yes.
And what did you say in relation to that?
Raising the dead?
Mm-hmm.
You want me to start from the whole thing or from
no,
the
no, 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 no. Just you spoke about raising the dead, right? We have 2 minutes left. So you spoke about raising the dead. What did you say specifically as it relates to that?
You know, every child of God has this grace over their lives. The Bible said the dead in Christ will resurrect. Mm-hmm. We have the power and the grace in Jesus. When we talk about resurrection, resurrection is Christ. Anybody that have Christ in them can pray for anybody who believe in miracles. And again, raising the dead is not in the power of any man. Raising the dead is in the power of the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I have witnessed it. I prayed for someone who was declared come back to life. I've seen it in many occasions. There are many, many manifestations of that. So raising the dead is not something
that.
So you're saying
that you have had experience where you've prayed somebody back to life?
That's right. That's right.
And you're saying that God can manifest this to anyone that accepts or has a yearning for it?
That's right. It is not specifically for an individual. The gift of God is for all men.
Okay.
The gift of God is. And again, you don't go out looking for the dead to raise. God must lead you. Mm. So this is not something that you think you have it and it's your like your personal gift. So you go around looking for the dead to raise. If the Lord does not lead you, you embarrass yourself.
Okay, then.
It sounds like it's going to be an amazing session.
So give us the venue and time again. We only have 30 seconds left.
I believe our pastor online will give us the venue.
Yes, it's
but before we leave, I ask that the Lord cover everybody, protect all of you. And I pray for all our presenters. I pray for the land. I declare the glory of God over everyone.
Thank you so much.
Please give the information and your phone number.
Yes, it's the Kuna Conference Building there at Fortlands. And for any information, you can call Pastor Vayomi Gumbs at 660-0251. And the conference starts at 7 p.m. So see you there.
It's tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow, Friday at 7 p.m. at the Kuna Building at Fortlands. My number again is 660-0251.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for sharing.
Thank you
okay?
So
yes.
God bless
thank
you, guys.
You.
No problem.
God bless
Take
you
a sharp
too.
Break and get back.
For the 2024 Rams Primary School Championships. On Thursday, March 21st, the Kim Collins Athletic Stadium has the fire. And on Friday, March 22nd and Saturday, March 23rd, the Sandy Point New Recreation Ground will be set ablaze. Admission on Thursday, March 21st is free. Yep, free. Admission on Friday, March 22nd is $10 children and $15 adults. Admission on Saturday, March 23rd is $15 children and $20 adults. Start time for all days is 12 p.m. sharp. So come on out and bring the family because it's fire on the track for the 2024 Rams Primary School Championships.
So we're back on Island Tea, and we've had such an interesting discussion. And of course, we encourage those persons out there. There's going to be a conference. Oh, we have a caller. Caller, go ahead. You're live on Island Tea.
Greetings for our DIT. Hey, I still. Hey, you're mesmerizing the rhythm instrumental in the I still. Wow! You make me jump for me drum. Oh, the music there. Up! I tell you, good choice. Yeah, you know we are talking about food a while ago.
Yes.
And our favorite, our favorite time in the Christendom world is the time where they call Easter time, you know.
Yes.
Oh, by the way, we are in spring now. We have entered the season of spring.
Let me just check. You could be, be right.
I'm in spring.
Mm-hmm. So the winter is over.
No. Confirm it for me, please.
Yeah, we'll confirm.
Right, we are in spring. Spring greetings to us. Spring is a good time. A spring time, they say we born, you know.
Yeah, so actually, we've been in spring. So spring starts from March 19th. And so you choose the March 19th at 11:06 p.m. For the Northern Hemisphere, when the sun was directly over the equator and its energy was in balance between the North and Southern Hemisphere, according to the National Weather Services. So, yeah, so... Yeah, what time is the first day of spring? They say March 19th.
Yeah, spring is a mystic highway, you know. Come in with the everything starts this way, you know. I mean, we don't observe the season because we're in this tropical, you know, space, but
yes.
the seasons. Big up to the farmers, them who use the almanac too.
Yeah, it also says that most years, the season typically, it says also most years, the season typically changes on March 20th or 21st, but they're saying that it started on the 19th this year, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll be talking about the month of March. We want to big up all March bonds.
Yes.
Don't know.
Pisces people.
Yes.
They make the observation and said that Women's International Day is the 8th of March, isn't it?
Yeah, it was the 8th of March.
Yes. And Her Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I's wife, Empress.
Yes.
They were Enoch Menin the First. She's a March born, you know. So it's coming up on the 25th. We want to say the greetings in advance. We're talking about food a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
And as we were saying, inside the Christendom world, this Lent time, because in this Lent time, there's an observation about abstaining from eating certain things. You all know that?
Yes.
Yes, in Lent, they don't eat. And, you know, we always knowing the importance of consuming as we ought to consume, you know, especially being in that kind of religious world. We are the temples, our bodies are the temples of the Most High. We welcome that and wish that we would have Lent all year round. Yes, we give thanks to the religious intervention a while ago. We certainly will attend because, you know, we read stories about the dead being raised, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But we came up in church, you know. That's where we get the name, the name what we have. when we listened about the raised of dead. And when we read that, we said, wow. Because we always see death as something that is not. It is something that we don't have to get. We don't have to accept. We don't have to.
it's not a must that a human being, we was created in the similitude of the Creator, immortality. The Christendom world said, well, you have to, because it's a choice, you know, it's the wages and the gift. The gift is eternal life, the wages is what we get when you do wrong, sin, whether wrong be. Oh, and we always see the first wrong as eating wrong. That's where it goes, because when you eat wrong, you think wrong. Most people don't treat that, but it's true. It can have a lot to do with your thoughts, decisions you make, etc., etc. We can go all day talking about that, but as I said, we welcome that and wish that we can have the length all around. I want to make a quick sound concerning something happened a while ago. Mm-hmm. Are we still online?
Yes, we're still here, and we're still here listening.
Could be better, because I get annoyed myself.
Mm-hmm.
In the utterance of time, when there is important meeting going on, that should go on for days and be resolved before we leave from the people talking about time. Ministers go up on radio talking about time. Ministers of government are talking about now, mm-hmm. right? Whereby the time, even if time involved, don't say it. Do not mention it. That's a turn off. Cut me off. In the midst of what I am saying, say to me, I have to go. We have to go. Yeah. So what Africa,
mm-hmm.
how Africa responded a while ago, it is understandable.
Mm-hmm.
It is not right to do that. I observe things in shows, like shows going on. And before the show end, somebody from the stage talking about the end of the show. That's a turn off. Let the show end. Don't talk about this and don't mention that. So we understand where Africa is coming from, and we pray that the other ones that make will be taken into consideration. Let me flow. Let me speak. Yes, you are observing your time. I am observing your time, too. I might not know that you have another guest on to come, but you know. So, therefore, all you do is, when I reach to the point where you have to get rid of me, you just say, I gone.
Okay, thank you for your contribution. Yes, thank you for your contribution. And of course, Africa, we invite you to call back. And of course, if you felt any way by that, we did not in any way have any intention to make you feel like your voice isn't necessary or that we don't want you to be calling in. So we encourage you to call in and continue to add to the show. Yes. Good day. We have a caller. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, hello.
Hey, good day.
Hey, good morning. Good morning to you guys, man. Yes.
Good morning. Good morning.
Yeah, I wanted to ask a quick question. Azard, anybody remember to mention the Agriculture Expo happening in Nevis today and tomorrow?
The Agriculture Expo?
Yeah, it's happening in Nevis today and tomorrow at the E.T. Willett Park.
Okay. Well, I guess by your question, you have given light to it, but we didn't mention it this morning.
The lady chef in the studio, right?
Yes,
I remember the other day she told a lady about her business. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to also ask her if she ever thought about participating at that event.
I wasn't aware of the event, but Nevis is definitely on my list. I'm supposed to be bringing my products to Nevis very shortly, so I've not forgotten Nevis at all. I just wasn't aware of this particular event.
Okay. And before I go, man, I want to pick up the man, Banky, over there on Nevis. He's going to be present today and tomorrow at the Agriculture Expo there at the E.T. Willett Park. He's a guy that's, you know, very prominent in the society over there in Nevis with the agriculture push. And he is the host of the Everything Agriculture Show every Tuesday evening, 7 to 9 p.m. on Vision Radio. So I want to big up the iBanky. He's going to be there present today and tomorrow, presenting himself, his products, etc. And he's pushing the marijuana issue and, you know, Shabazz Organics. So lovely, I want to ask everyone to come on out and support him. You know what I mean? People over in Sinkis, you're welcome to come over and check the man Banky out today and tomorrow at the Agriculture Expo show at the E.T. Willett Park. Yeah, so big up yourself, Banky, man. One love and much success to the eye today and tomorrow. And you guys have
much
a good day, man.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yes. Yes.
So there's an act.
Oh, we have another call. Caller, go ahead.
Good morning, Mr. Gumbs, and your guest, Jim.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The gentleman didn't talk about the fee, the charging of fee by the gate.
It didn't seem so. I'm going to look for the poster. I think a poster was shared. From my knowledge, I don't think it's a fee.
He sound powerful. Lazar, I don't know how old you are, but I remember your man, he come from somewhere, I think he's American, your brother Shamba.
Yes.
And he had a concert in the park, and when people went up to pray, you hear?
Mm-hmm.
I never know demon could have lived in people, so you hear?
Mm-hmm.
You ever hear anybody talk about it?
No.
Vaguely, I remember.
1973.
Okay? What happened?
In Warner Park.
Okay.
A lady went up on the stage and he started to perform.
Mm-hmm.
And the demon started to talk. Said, let me go, Shamba, me now come out. Let me go, Shamba, and I come out and see whatever I hear and something. Mm-hmm. Monster, me now come out. Let me tell you.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't go home the night. I was afraid to death. I never know.
You're afraid?
That demon could have lived in people's so. And a lady tell me a time that she and a pastor went up performing too. And the pastor tell them, if you in strongly believe, do not come. Because the demon leave the person could live in you. And when she start to, they start to pray for the man. The demon telling the lady, why you don't let me alone? You waiting now to say you all, you're a Christian. You remember all the dance and thing you used to go to. And the pastor, they praying and they sweating.
Wow.
Till they get the demon out the man. So. He's the man, so lucky, he's a powerful man. So I think, Lazar, you must ask your mother or somebody about 1973, okay, Warner Park. Yeah.
And here it says...
Demon, could, I know the lady.
Yes.
I know the lady for a long time. She used to walk up and down on the road, but I didn't know that if somebody messed with the lady. So sometimes you see people on the road, sometimes people that say the devil, but... Trust me, these things is real.
It's free admission, so it's no charge. So you could go. Thank you for your contribution. There's no fee tomorrow. There's no fee.
Okay, all right. Okay, thank you.
Yes. Bye. Okay.
You know, as I just know, the lady talking about demon possession, right? And you're over there like, it's free admission. There's no charge. I'm like, what?
So, yes. I'm not sure if they which year?
In St. Kitts, was there a child?
There was one like this before.
In St. Kitts, the one they have here.
convent. The convent one?
No. The agriculture.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, but in Nevis, it's free.
So many conversations
I know,
happening.
Right?
Yes, so... Yes, we have another caller. Caller, you're live on LNT.
Hey, good morning, good morning.
Hey, good morning.
You know, your mission is, you know.
Say that again?
You got to cast somebody in demon on the radio. You understand?
Well,
they're seeing things that are not so.
Mm-hmm.
Good morning to all of the guests.
Good morning.
This breadfruit queen. It's queen of the breadfruit.
Thank you. Mm. Thank you.
Do you buy breadfruit from people?
Yes, we do, actually.
Are you have enough?
We buy breadfruit from people all the time. Hello? We have persons that pick for us. We go to the market and we buy anywhere we see breadfruit, we buy it.
Mm-hmm. My pastor got a good breadfruit tree.
Mm-hmm.
I think she said the Jamaican, that's my mama.
Oh.
Miss George.
Okay.
Yeah, she can get... My dog, cat, or the devil is married.
Okay.
She said, "Save me when you call my name." But she, I think she told me she sells to the Jamaican.
Okay, good okay.
Quality breadfruit.
Yeah.
At what stage do you pick them up?
We like them when they.
When they start to get ripish.
When they're full, but not too ripe.
I like them full.
Mm-hmm.
I like them half full. Now, I was since in the week, I was trying to call in to tell you about the Nevis. agriculture exhibition.
Yes.
I was surprised when I heard somebody talking about this St. Kitts one, because the Nevis one is usually very large and they have a whole agro-processing thing.
Wow.
There's a lot of kitchens go over.
Okay.
Go over to buy, because you know they make ham and all kind of stuff. Yes, oh, so maybe if you were paying attention, you know, Miss Bedford, you could have go over, even send over your stuff. Mm-hmm. Not too late, guys, today and tomorrow.
And I really want to get some breadfruit from Nevis, too, because depends on where.
No time to go up today.
Definitely.
Boat running.
Yeah, going to have to try that, for real.
Carry Kortensia with you.
I'll call her.
Yeah, when they hear the voice, they're going to say, oh, my God, lady, I'm in a family, get free breadfruit.
I like that. Rollins, that's where we go for breadfruit. Oh, thank you. I'll definitely remember that.
Yeah, Rollins Village. That's where my grandfather come from. My mother, father, Freeman.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So all of you over, you must give them your number before you leave.
Yeah.
You could even send them the breadfruit and the sea hustle or whatever.
Any Nevis contacts up there? Anybody with breadfruit or you have any information on breadfruit? 665.
Yeah, tell them what kind of quality.
665-7612. Full. Nice full breadfruit, not too ripe. But definitely not green. Definitely full.
Well, so this is the opportunity today. Mm-hmm. You know, to get your breadfruit from Nevis.
Thanks for looking out for me, Sylvie. Thank you.
Well, you know, that's my job, you know.
I know.
Since I can't see, I got to look out.
Oh, Lord. Thank you.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So all the best. I like your spirit, you know, so well, whenever I think they get rid of one, they got 20 on Michelin last night.
Yes.
And the another station.
Yes.
So well, we never die, you know.
Well, you know.
Pass on the torch, you know what I mean?
Yeah. We need
because
people
like us.
People
to lay it back.
We need the startups, you know. We need.
I mean, continuity. That's why I continue. No matter what they say, they can rush me up.
Mm-hmm.
We need continuity.
Now, the thing about the time, I don't understand the protest. Because the truth is, if you tell me, look, you have the next 2 minutes, I therefore would time myself by that. It was never intended to offend.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, and sometimes we don't even think so, you know. You know, sometimes some things happen, and somebody said, girl, you ain't say we went on with you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you didn't even take it as anything. You understand what I mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
People are stubborn people. They have my good friend from Winnie from Oban said, I said, Lord, I don't know. He leave all of the training in Winnie FM room. Nobody. The big guy instruction. Well, let me send you come in. But I like him, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I like him. And if I have information that I think can be shared, I share it. You either receive it or reject it.
Yeah.
Now, to the food story, even though we ate a lot of vegetables, there was a high rate of malnutrition. I don't know how sometimes we stay away from it.
Yeah.
The children were sickly. That's why they gave cod liver oil to, you know? Maybe some of us don't know. Their diet was low in vitamin B.
Mm-hmm.
And this I know from research, eh?
Yeah.
In 1989, I think, a study was done on the situation analysis of women and children in St. Kitts.
Mm-hmm.
It showed as high as 40% of the children under 5 were moderately mal. And children used to die from malnutrition in St. Kitts all up in the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So and another thing that they used to do, I say my parents, while they had fowls that laid eggs, instead of cooking the eggs, they would sell them and buy salted food, mackerel and saltfish.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so sometimes it was even brought out in a study that when the planters were complaining about the people were lazy and they wouldn't come to work, the truth is that they were malnourished.
Food again.
The sucker cane, the cane ain't got enough. I mean, they got in sugar and stuff, but no vitamins.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
They couldn't afford to buy, like, a widow buy chicken. You know, chicken was a Sunday.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So that meals were low. Low in protein and low in vitamin B. I mean, people, you scale. When I say scale food,
That's true. And I always say, you know, we look at information, but back then, the healthcare and everything, taking care of yourself wasn't as good as we do now. Persons are living longer.
Yeah, but sometimes when we're glorifying these things, I was even told, when you call him politician name, he advised the people to stop eating so much yam and thing.
Mm-hmm.
And try and get some more things. And when I asked him, mango boil, you know mango boil?
Mango
you heard about mango boil, right? About
mango.
when you eat, mango boiling is
like boil, mango boil. Boil.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We don't see them now. When mango season is in, Lord, we eat so much. One day, Sylvia Manning, she is the nutrition surveillance officer. She should have a copy of the study if one of you interested.
Because
she's getting, I think, shoulder than me. Anyway, and she revealed that the reason why people were getting mango boils and so in the food season was because their body had been low in vitamin A.
Mm-hmm.
So when they consumed the last, mango season, you know, we eat mango by the bucket and so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it resulted in this lot of boil breaking out. You know what did that?
Mango so that was like a detox or something? They were short in the vitamin, and then when the vitamin was introduced into the system, they got that.
You know, you only could have water, but eat the mango then when they're in season, mostly in the summertime. So these things showed up. So sometimes when we glorify, we ate this and we ate that. People have diabetes, but the truth is, they work so hard. They work in the cane field. They have to go on the farm, or it's called farmer holding. Work again, they work it off.
People
look older and the age.
Yeah, hard work does that to you. But I think, too, right, that there needs to be some sort of balance. And it depends on where you come from. Because I come from the country area. And to me...
It is easier now.
You think so?
Your bread. Yes.
Well, it's easier to acquire a lot of food.
You could have a protein to go with it. You could have fish.
This must be something. We have to look at this because sometimes we quote stuff and we don't look at the context and the where. Because I don't know if this was for the Bastia area or wherever, but I know in the country area, like growing up, like everybody had eggs. We had fishermen. Meat was never an issue. A lot of it would be information and education too.
Maybe because I live in Bastia, right? And village is next to Fortland. Fortland in the village. We go around and we sell them.
Because I find even as a country girl, when I came to Bastia to live, it was like chalk and cheese. It was worlds apart, you know? I mean, when I go and I see people buying, I remember a time in the market, I see people buying a handful of pigeon peas in the shell for $5. I almost faint. Even when I started buying lunch, I say the peas, we would joke and say that the rice have been 3 peas. Whereas when you come from the country, these things are such abundance.
Like my parents, we had a peas patch, peas patch, right?
Mm-hmm.
I even had one in my yard.
We had our when whole you fence was peas.
The Christmas, man, your mother cooking peas and rice. But we it's only, only when the peas were in season. That is the point.
So I think, again, it has to do with where you came from as well.
Yeah.
And which part you lived as
Miss Henry,
well,
we...
All right, then. Don't run me now. I don't have that for you to get a call on Africa for you.
Yes.
And that's my family.
Yes.
Anyway, y'all don't be offended. God bless everybody.
Thank you so much. So we have about a few more minutes before the conclusion of this program.
Yes.
We also recognize that there is supposed to be something starting at 10 shortly.
Carib Wave.
So we, as soon as Island Tea ends at 10, the Carib Wave begins, and so you're going to hear an announcement, and this is what you would hear in light if in the event that there's a
tsunami.
In the unlikely event that there's a tsunami, there's a sound that is going to be played. So we've had so many discussions, so many things, you know. Chev, what are your, out of all the things that we spoke about this morning, what resonates with you most?
Why so much? So it was a really light-hearted, really. We covered so much, in a very light-hearted way. It was really good today. It was fun, yeah, it was fun. everything.
I just,
down to raising of the dead. Everything.
I am here looking at your face and I think it, and this only, you know, I can't even say it on radio, but I think it in terms of the comment that you made. Yes, we're going to just think. So it's so many things that we discuss, but this is what Island Tea is all about. It's all about diversity, variation,
mm-hmm.
and we want to make so sure variety. Sorry, and we want to make sure that, you know, persons are free to express their views,
yes,
in a respectful manner, and one that is, you know. And again, to Africa, I by no means have anything against you. I do like your contribution.